One day Augustine, he got a bishop, no? He got nice gold ring. He brought the ring and showed, "Mommy, mommy, I want to show you something." "What?" "Look what I have got. Golden ring, big ring with a diamond." She said, "Wait for a minute." She went inside and brought a old ring which has lost its so much of shape because his father had kicked his mother. So the ring of Monica went here and there. The ring which her husband gave during wedding day. So she showed, "If I have not taken care of this ring, you would not have got that ring," she said. Life is a journey. As we read in James chapter 1, verse 4 to 5, "Amidst many trials and tribulations, God will speak to us. God will reveal to us." 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 6 to 7. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 6 to 7. God will speak to us through our trials. Sometime we will be like thrown into the burning fire. Why? The gold comes with this mud. In the fire, the mud is gone away. Then you have only the gold. In order to give you the gold of your presence, gold of yourself, the essence of you, deep will be calling you to deep. And how revelation is important, and how this revelation is revealed to us through the word. Yes, the more we walk in the word, we hear the word, we confess through our lips, continues to confess our lips, in his time, in his ways, he will reveal. And when we obey that, life is being built. Lord, when I go through, when Paul was in the jail, he started to write Philippians book, the book of Philippians, where he says, in the jail, he did not get food. So the enemy is attacking his mind and saying, "You are saying, Jesus, Jesus, you are preaching the word of God. Look at you, poor fellow. You are being jailed. You are being beaten up. And you have no food." The enemy is attacking him on the mind. And so, he opens his mind to the revelation. And that revelation becomes the word of God. And that revelation was, I know whether in every moment how to live, whether I am hungry or full, I can do everything through Christ who strengthens me. My strength comes from God. My power comes from God. My daddy knows everything of me. My daddy is a living God. Yes. So when we read the word, when we read the word through the revelation, when we read the word, the revelation comes to us, and the revelation leads us to the faith, to hold on to the Lord. Let anything happen, I and my family will serve the Lord. Like Job, you see, "I don't understand what is happening to me, but one thing I am sure, my Redeemer is living." So when you hold on to the revelation, when you continue to confess the word of God, there the life of faith is being built. You begin to tell like Job, "I don't understand." Job says, "I go on the east, he is not found. I go on the west, I don't find him. But I see him leading me on. I see him leading me on. I go to the east, he is not found. I go to the west, I have not found him. I am asking people, they also don't know. But I see my God leading me on." When you hold on to the Lord, you begin to recognize the Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I need in my life. It's true. It's true. The enemies are after me, but I see my God anointing my head with oil and protecting me. It is true. The Lord leading me through dark valleys, but He has not left me. He has given me His staff and crook to guide my steps that I may not fall. He has not given me His staff and crook and to walk in heaven. He leads me in the deep valleys, dark valleys. This is the revelation of David. You will walk through dark valleys, but God will provide you the staff and your crook. Crook is a kind of instrument, a kind of stick that you may not fall. Yes. And all through my life, His goodness, His kindness will follow me. All through my life, I may go through problem. I may go through struggle. I may go through pain. I may go through the things which I don't understand. But along with that, His kindness, His goodness will follow me all the days of my life. That is my life. My life is not without problem, but my life is with the presence of God. God will lead me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the more we enter into the word, the more we cling on to the revelation, the faith is being given to us. And when we move with the darkness, I rejoice in the Lord. You begin to say, like the prophet who said in Habakkuk chapter 3, he says, verse 16 onwards, even if all the flocks die from the stall, verse 18 onwards, let everything goes away from me, still there is no crop in my field, still I will rejoice in my God, my Savior. I will rejoice in my Lord. What happens to me is not the matter. What the Lord does through me is matter. My life is not what's happening to me, but what am I becoming in the Lord? What is the purpose of my God? And how the purpose of God is being fulfilled in my life? Jesus said in John chapter 4, verse 24, to do the will of my Father is my food. Yes, my food is to do the will of my Father. Yes, that's why in the book of Hebrews chapter 10, verse 5 onwards, Jesus said, Father, you have given me a body for what? To eat biryani and to sit and enjoy? No, you have given me a body. Here I am. I come to do your will. And looking at him, what is he going to do with his body? John says in John's Gospel chapter 1 verse 28, He is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of this world. This man's body will be broken into pieces like a lamb. He will shed his blood. He will be scourged. Nobody can see his face. He is the Lamb of God who will take away the sins of the world. A revelation is given to Jesus through John. And that revelation made Jesus to face the trials. That's why he told the woman of Jerusalem, don't cry for me. Cry for you and for your children. If the tree is green, it can face the fire. If the tree is dried out, few minutes are enough. Keep up the sap of the tree. Keep up the root of your tree. Keep up the anointing of the tree which comes from the revelation.